Hey guys, it's Alexis from Sims VIP. I hope you're all doing well. So I've been getting a lot of requests on YouTube to do a video showing you guys how to download and install custom content and mods in The Sims 4. Originally, I did an article on simsvip.com, which is in the description below, and it's a write-up about how to install custom content. Not mods, just custom content. So this video is going to include mods and stuff, and just FYI, I'm going to be doing this video at a beginner standpoint. So obviously this is probably the only people that this kind of video is going to help, because either you're just starting out or you're debating whether or not you want to start. All right, a couple things first, some precautions. Obviously, understand that EA unofficially supports custom content and mods. They encourage it, but they won't support it if something happens to your game. So just keep that in mind. If something happens, you know, they can't help you. And then the second thing is always be aware of where you're downloading and what you're downloading. Mod the Sims and Sims Resource are the two top websites for downloading anything. So if you want somewhere to start, that's where I'd suggest you go. Another place for you to go is My Sims 4 blog. They actually have a whole database organized and everything labeled categories of every single thing that exists out there for The Sims 4. They've been around since The Sims 3, and maybe even Sims 2. I don't really know. But they have everything there. So if you're not sure if there's a specific creator that you should download from them, if you find it on their site, then you're good to go. Obviously, they might miss things too, but you know, that's not to say that anything that's not there is bad. Just saying, if you're starting out, start somewhere. And those are the three sites that you should start at. Until you get used to it and you get the hang of it and you feel more comfortable, you know, making those decisions on your own. All right. Aside from that, I also want to make sure I stress this enough. Anytime you install third-party stuff to your game, please remove it from your folder before you update your game. Anything that you have installed, you need to remove it. Not that something's gonna most definitely happen, but I'll tell you this. I've seen horror stories of people who have left in mods that are, you know, very complex mods, and then they leave it in and then they never update it, and then eventually they lose their saved game. So if you're not backing and saving and backing up all your stuff all the time, and you're downloading things and you're not paying attention, there's a good chance you're gonna lose your, you know, something's gonna happen. So just as a precaution, just remove this stuff before you update, and then you eliminate all the hassle. Okay, those are basically the three major precautions. You know, EA doesn't really support it. Make sure you know where you're downloading from and remove the stuff from your game before you update. All right, let's see, what else here? Well, I guess I'll start off by explaining some basic stuff. So first and foremost, mods and custom content are two different things. Custom content is basically any object or item that you're going to utilize and create a sim or build in buy mode. And mods are things that you install in your game that alter gameplay. Whether it's adding something like unlocking reward objects or enabling male pregnancy. It really ranges from very simple stuff to very complex stuff. Custom content comes in two different forms. There's default and non-default. Default content is going to replace an item that already exists in the game from EA. A non-default item will either add to it, meaning a recolor or something similar, or be a completely new object altogether. Mods come in both script and non-script forms. The script mods are actually mods that are going to go into the game code and change gameplay. So if, for example, male pregnancy, that's something that takes a lot of complex code work, and whoever created that mod obviously took a lot of time to do that, but that's a very complex mod. So that's a mod that you're gonna, you know, that actually changes the gameplay of the game. Now, a non-script mod would probably be something simple like, I don't know, unlocking reward objects. I don't want to label anything specific because it can really range. It could be something simple that's still a script mod. Just so you understand, there's two different types. And one of them is, you know, the script mod is very complex. So those are things that are going to change. And that's why it's very good to remove this stuff before you update your game. Because once the code changes, the mods are usually pretty useless, especially script mods. until they're updated again. So that's another thing. Make sure anytime there's an update, you check with the creators and make sure that there's an update, or wait a couple days, whatever it is. Don't play with it until you know it's safe to use. All right. Let's start off here. If you to find your mods folder, first and foremost, you need to go to your Sims 4 folder. So Documents, Electronic Arts, The Sims 4, and Mods. The Mods folder is already in there, standard, default. EA put it in there, and inside the Mods folder is the resource file. This is the file that enables custom content and mods for use in the game. So this is already there. If you accidentally delete it or something, it'll automatically regenerate itself the next time you turn on the game, so don't even worry about that. You'll be fine. All right, let's see. So this is it. This is where all your stuff's going to go. So I'm going to start off here. Let me show you guys how to actually download and install this stuff. All right. I'm going to start off here with A3 Rue. They have a set of lips here, which is actually an additional item for Create a Sim. And, they always read what it is. I know what it is already because I've gone through it. And once you find the download button, you go ahead and download it. This one here that I downloaded, these pair of lips, are down here in the bottom of the screen. It is a .dot package file. Now, custom content is always going to be in a package form. There might be like rare cases maybe that they come in something different, but I haven't run into anything other than package files, and I'm pretty sure that's the only way they can be. So there is always .dot package. That means that as is, you can automatically put it into the mods folder directly from your downloads folder, or if you want to move these to your desktop as you're downloading so they're separate, they literally go directly in there as a package file. Now, I went over to 1 billion pixels, and she had, or he had, these headphones that were for download, and I went ahead and downloaded them. And this is the second download you see down here at the bottom of the screen, the OBP headphones. Now this is a different file. It's a zip file. In order to open zip files or even have them download properly with what's inside, you need to have some kind of decompression software like WinZip or WinRAR or 7-Zip. Usually they're all free. I mean, I downloaded it from WinZip. Mine was free. So basically just go to those websites, find your computer specs and everything and download the correct one, and then you have a program that's able to extract files from the zip folders. Now, the reason they put them in zip folders is because usually it's because it's more than one, or it might be a very large file. And that way putting it in here allows them to upload it without, you know, it being like 80 gigabytes or something, you know. So once you download something like a zip file, you're gonna go ahead and open it up. Inside, you're either gonna find the package files or a folder that contains the package files. A lot of creators also like to include screenshots of their work so you know what you've downloaded. And here you can see there are two separate package files. These package files can literally be dragged and placed right into the mods folder, or if you wanna put them on your desktop or something like that while you're downloading, that's fine too. These go directly right into your mods folder as is, as a package file. You're not going to put the entire zip file. So this thing down here that downloaded, you're not putting that in there. You're opening it up and putting these two files. So whenever you run into this, that's what you're going to do. And that's how custom content works. So I'm going to go ahead here. I have my mods folder open, and I'm going to take one of these over and I'm going to place it right here. And there you go. That's it. It's in the mods folder. Finished. That's it. Once you start your game, that file will be in there. Always make sure you read what you're downloading with custom content. Sometimes you will have to download additional items to get the item you want to work. There's all kinds of scenarios, so always make sure you read the instructions and always read what the creator has to say. All right. Next up, I'm over here at Twisted Mexican's Reddit, where he has a wiki with a bunch of mods and stuff, cheats for the game. So I went ahead and downloaded the Unlock All Build Buy content. Those are for the rewards that you can only unlock if you're in a career. So this mod actually twists the code and, you know, allows it so that you don't have, you enter a cheat code and voila, everything's unlocked. Which now we have our cheat code anyways, with since the last patch, but that's not the point. All right, so I went ahead and downloaded it here, and it's, again, it's a zip file. When you go ahead and open it, you will notice that there is another zip file in here. Whoa, no. Well, inside of this zip file are two files that end in .pyo. Okay, these are files that cannot be placed into the mods folder. The only things that can go individually are going to be package files. So if these were package files, then you could just take them out and put them in your mods folder. However, this is a more complex mod. This is a script mod. This is a mod that's going to alter code in the game. And in that case, I read his instructions. You actually have to take the folder itself as a zip file and put it into your mods folder for it to work. So, like I said, mods can be very easy to install, but then they can go very complex. So something like this, you're gonna want to read the instructions properly. I know the mod that enables male pregnancy over at Mod The Sims, that one requires a separate folder in another directory in your computer. So when I tell you it can get really complex, it really can. So always read the instructions. This one here is fairly simple. You open up the zip file you downloaded, take the zip file that's inside of it, and put it in here. So like I said, it's gonna be different with every mod that you download, but again, read the instructions. As far as custom content goes, if you download package files, download them, put them directly in the mods folder. That's it, you're done. You boot your game and everything is in there. If you have any issues like crashing or problems after installing an item, you know, make sure you go back and read the creator's comments or possibly leave them some feedback letting them know that you're having an issue. Somebody else might have an answer for you. So that is it. This is how you download and install mods. It's fairly simple, but at the same time, take precautions and know what you're doing. That's it for this video. I hope I answered your questions and I hope you guys understood this and I wasn't overdoing it, but